Los Angeles. He walks again by night. Out of the fog, into the smog. Relentlessly, ruthlessly.
I wonder where Ruth is.
Doggedly, toward his weekly meeting with the unknown. At 4th and Drucker, he turns left. At Drucker and 4th, he turns right. He crosses MacArthur Park and walks into a great sandstone building.
Oh, my nose!
Groping for the door, he steps inside. Climbs the 13 steps to his office. He walks in. He's ready for mystery. He's ready for excitement. He's ready for anything. He's...
Nick Danger, Third Eye.
I want to order a pizza to go and no anchovies.
No anchovies? You've got the wrong man. I spell my name, Danger.
What?
The makers of fantastic cigarettes, long in the leaf and short in the can, bring you another true story from the tattered casebook of Nick Danger, Third Eye. Let's join him now in the adventure we call...
Cut him off at the past!
Let's get down to business. Uncross those beautiful stems of yours, baby. Here's the case I call number 666. It all began innocently enough on Tuesday. I was sitting in my office on that drizzly afternoon, listening to the monotonous staccato of rain on my desktop and reading my name on the glass of my office door. Regnad Kisten. My secretary lay snoring on the floor, her long, beautiful gams pinioned under the couch. I didn't hear him enter, but my nostrils flared at the smell of his perfume. Pyramid patchouli. There was only one joker in L.A. sensitive enough to wear that scent. And I had to find out who he was.
Good afternoon, Mr. Danger. I'm Rocky Rococo.
Thanks, Half Pint. You just saved me a lot of investigative work.
Maybe yes, maybe no. Do you know what this is?
I had to think for a minute. What cruel game was he playing?
That's a brown paper bag.
That's correct. Now, look inside, Mr. Danger. What do you see?
That's easy. That's a pickle.
Very good. Now I think you're ready for this.
Why, that's nothing but a two-bit ring from a crackerback, Jocks.
I'll sell it to you for $5,000.
What kind of a chump do you take me for?
First class.
That tarnished piece of tin is worthless.
Worthless? Not to Melanie Haber.
Melanie Haber?
You may remember her as Audrey Farber.
Audrey Farber?
Susan Underhill?
Susan Underhill?
How about Betty Jo Bielowski?
Betty Jo Bielowski. I hadn't heard that name since college. Everyone knew her as Nancy. Then it all came rushing back to me like the hot kiss at the end of a wet fist. It was pig night at the Om Mani Padme Sigma house. We had escaped from the crowd and stood trembling under the dwarf maples.
Oh, Nicky, I don't know what to say. This is the most beautiful ring I've ever seen.
Yeah, Nancy, it's really neat. It cost me $5,000.
Oh, Nicky, how can I ever repay you?
Well, gee whiz, Nancy. How about 500 down and a 36-month contract?
What?
Or you could marry me.
That's impossible, Nick. I can't marry you. I can't even tell you why. Maybe someday.
All right, Nancy. I understand. Sign here.
Oh, Nick. I'll never forgive you.
And I'll never forget you neither, Nancy.
And that's why I called you today, Nancy. I mean, Mrs. Haber. Something reminded me of that time so long ago under the dwarf maples.
I don't know what prompted you to get in touch with me, but you called just in the nick of time.
You haven't lost your delicate sense of humor, have you, Nancy?
What? Nick, I can't talk to you now. You have to get out here right away. My husband, it's the same old place in Santa Barbara, Nicky. Oh, hurry, Nicky, I need you.
Nancy! I slipped the ring into my nose and the receiver into my pocket and headed for the door quickly. But I'd forgotten the little man with the evil grin.
Just a second, Danger. What about my pickle?
You're lucky you still have your brown paper bag, small change.
Danger, you haven't seen the last of me.
No, but the first of you turns my stomach.
You'll be hearing from me again, Danger.
I headed down the hall in the opposite direction toward the fire escape. I hadn't a moment to lose.
Hey! Danger! Where's the fire?
In your eyes, Lieutenant Bradshaw.
Don't get wise with me, Peeper. You're lucky we didn't burn you on the Anselmo pederasty case.
Look, you caught him, didn't you?
Yeah, but the punk got away, no thanks to you.
Well, what brings your flat feet sniffing around here now, copper?
Just a friendly word of advice, Danger.
Yeah, what?
Don't go sticking your big nose into police business.
Sure, Lieutenant. Is that all?
No. Don't talk with your mouth full.
Okay, Bradshaw.
And don't fidget while I talk to you.
Sure,
and
Lieutenant.
Stop tracking mud across my nice,
okay.
Clean...
Okay. When I hit the street, the rain had already turned L.A. into a mud river. It was a short swim down Alvarado to my convertible. I had to get to Santa Barbara in a big hurry. As I whipped onto Mulholland Drive, the lights were just twinkling on across the San Fernandino Valley. I could barely make them out through the driving rain. Then a hard right down Big Tujunga Canyon. My tires squealed as I hit Sepulveda. A right, a left, a left, another right, a left to the body, a right, and into a gas station. Hey, Pop!
All right, hold your horses, I'm coming.
Hey, yeah?
Where am I?
You can't get there from here.
But I'm looking for the same old place.
Oh, you must mean the old same place, sonny. It's right out back. Here's the key.
4 hours later, I parked my car in the carriage house and walked up the gray gravel driveway between a line of dwarf maples toward the pillared entrance of the same mansion. It had been snowing in Santa Barbara ever since the top of the page, and I had to shake the cornstarch off my mucklucks as I lifted the heavy obsidian door knocker. Hey in there! Open up! Your door knocker fell off.
What's all this brouhaha?
Brouhaha?
Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha.
Wait a minute. Don't you want this door knocker?
I already have one.
But this is yours.
You see? I told you. We used to have another one, but he vanished mysteriously. All right, come in out of the cornstarch and dry your mucklucks by the fire. Let me introduce myself. I am Nick Danger.
No, let me introduce myself. I am Nick Danger.
If you're so smart, why don't you pick up your cues faster?
Are those my cues?
Yes, and they must be dry by now. Why don't you pull them up out of the cellophane before they scorch? All right, sir. May I take your hat and coat?
Yes.
I assume you've come to see my mistress, Mr. Danger.
I don't care about your private life or what his name is. I've come to see Nancy... Mrs. Haber.
Mrs. Haber?
Audrey Farber.
Audrey Farber?
How about Betty Jo Bialowski?
Oh, you mean Nancy. Well, she's in the aviary stunting trees. I shall return with her straight away. You may wait here in the sitting room, or you can sit here in the waiting room.
There was something fishy about the butler. I think he was a Pisces, probably working for scale. I felt a thin shiver run up my spine as I sat down on the cold marble floor. What was it about this place? The atmosphere was as phony as the Tudor balustrade that leered at me from the top of the staircase. And there she stood, radiant. All those curves showing through that flimsy burnous. It was Nancy running down the stairs. All the familiar sounds and smells of pig night came rushing back like a good snort of scotch. Then it struck me. 20 years later, and she still knocked me out.
Oh, Nick,
where
darling,
am I?
Nick, Nick, wake up. Are you all right?
Yes.
Oh, then stop slapping me.
Nancy. What's the bird's eye lowdown on this caper? Whatever that means.
Nick, we can't talk here. We can't talk here.
What does it mean we can't talk here?
We can't talk.
Oh, you're right, we can't. What's the way to do about
follow
that?
Follow me. This way. This is much better. We're at the chapel now. It's soundproofed, so no one can hear us.
What did you say?
I said no one can...
What?
Never mind. Follow me.
What?
Here, take my hand. This way. This is much better.
Yeah, pretty fancy layout you've got here, Nancy. What's this, your boudoir?
Oh, no, these are the kennels.
Putting on the dog, eh? Well, say, where are all the doggies?
They've mysteriously disappeared.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, I just told you. Along with the servants. They were very attached to one another.
Where?
at the wrist and ankles.
Wait a minute. You said all the servants had disappeared.
Did I?
What about your butler?
You mean Catherwood?
Yes, madam.
Oh, Catherwood. Oh, you startled me.
I'm sorry, madam.
What are you doing there on all fours?
I'm looking for my script. Why don't you just go on without me?
Listen, Nancy, I smell a rat.
So do I. I think he's got my script.
Oh, yes, Catherwood, you look for it, all right?
All right,
you,
madam.
Nick, quickly, through this sacred panel.
All right. Over here.
This is the portrait gallery.
This is the portrait... There's an echo in here. This is the portrait gallery, Nick. It's the safest room in the mansion. No one can find us here.
All right, Nancy. Get your hands off me. What's the scoop?
Chocolate, butterscotch, or Rocky Rococo? Road!
That reminded me. How had she gotten herself involved with that slimy weasel Rococo? And how do I make my voice do this?
Oh, Nick. It all began 20 years ago with the mysterious disappearance of my husband.
You mean you were already married when I sold you that ring?
No wonder she hadn't been able to meet the payments.
What?
So that was your secret. Oh, what a sap I've been.
Oh, yes. But that night, the strangest thing happened.
That usually goes along with being just married.
My husband, Johnny, he... Oh, Nick, I want to tell you the horrible truth, the whole truth, all of it. The man behind everything.
Gee, madam.
Let me handle this, Nancy. Far out, Catherwood. Just roll a couple of bombers and leave them on the side table.
Yes, madam. Oh, I say. Pardon me, madam. I seem to have crashed. It's been such a long exposition, you know. I'm so tired.
Catherwood.
Yes, sir.
Catherwood, can't you see you're upsetting Nancy? Leave us alone.
Well, how much would you like, sir? 500? 1,000?
I am Scray Osterbay.
Oh, of course, sir. Ook-ook-a-chook, sir.
Gesundheit.
Yes. I'm so tired. I haven't slept.
All right, Nancy, go on with your story. Start with your dreadful secret.
Oh, Nick, I can't. I'm so confused.
Well, why don't you just hold your thumb next to your line? See, like this. Huh? Like, this way I don't get confused and I never lose my place.
I feel faint. The whole world is spinning.
Why, that's lucky for us, Nancy. If it were flat, all the Chinese would fall off. Why, she's no fun. She fell right over. Wait a minute. Didn't I say that line on the other side of the record? Where am I? I'd better check.
Who is now?
It's okay. They're speaking Chinese. Poor Nancy. She's fainted. I'll just wrap her skirt around her head like this to keep her warm. And now I'll press her body close to mine to keep me warm.
She looked so helpless there, spread-eagled on the floor. I beat the eagle off and gave her a quick mouth-to-mouth resuscitation job. And then it struck me.
What a sap she had!
Good girl, Nancy. That ought to hold him for a while.
Poor Nicky. He's bleeding. I'll tear this strip off my petticoat.
You want to?
There. You tie him up with this. I'll go through his pockets.
All right. Careful. Don't wake him up.
Oh, that contract must be on him somewhere.
Audrey.
You fools!
What?
Haven't you found the contract yet? Your time is almost up.
Rococo, you slimy blackmailer. How did you get in here? You don't have a key?
No, only half a key.
What?
I had to split it with a sound effects man.
Oh.
Where is the contract, you absent-minded old fraud?
Wait a minute. Here it is. I found it. It was taped to his leg.
Give me that. Ha-ha.
Oh.
I've got it at last.
All right. Now maybe you'll leave us in peace, Rococo. Give me the negative.
Of course. Here it is.
Oh, at last. Now we're out of your evil clutches.
Dan, wait a minute. Look at this negative. It isn't us. It's an interesting approach, but it isn't us.
She's right. What are you trying to pull on me, Rococo?
Oh, my goodness. I must have sent the wrong negative to the police. I must have left yours in the car. I'll go get it.
A second, Rococo. You're not going nowhere until you've explained what you've done with that filthy piece of blackmail.
Are you threatening me? Why, you stupid toad! I ought to beat your brain out!
No! Put down that pickle!
You'll never get away with this, Rococo!
Oh, yeah? Didn't you ever see Casablanca?
The thick veil of pain lifted enough for me to eyeball the situation. Rococo, that sleazy weasel, how did he get in here? And what was he doing with that pickle in one hand and my contract in the other? I had no choice. Nancy and the old butler were frozen with terror. I struggled quietly to my feet and flung myself head first at Rococo's stomach.
You saved our life.
This ain't no time for ticker tape parades, baby. Get me out of these ropes and into a good belt of scotch.
Let me hold that contract for you, Mr. Danger.
I'll keep that contract, Catherwood. But you can take this pickle off my hands.
Oh, no, I think you better hold on to that, Nick.
Good thinking, sweetheart. Lieutenant Bradshaw will need all the evidence he can get.
Yes. And you should stick around, too, Danger. You can help him put all the pieces together, you know.
Right.
No. A left.
I felt like I was being kicked in the head by the whole chorus line at Minsky's. So Nancy was in on this caper. I felt myself going under. The biggest long shot, Louis at Hialeah, wouldn't put a fin on my fate now. This time, something told me I was out for lunch. I even began to hear things.
I'll never forget. Keep your nose on business, Danger. May I take your hat and coat, sir?
We'll be back to Nick Danger after this message.
All right, hold it right where you are. I'm Lieutenant Bradshaw with a piece of advice for you. Now, here in the studio, it's all knuckles and know-how. But when that red light goes off, I'm just plain Harry Ames, citizen and weekend father. Now, take a tip from a cop who does. Radio work can be just as dirty and exciting as hunting down public enemy number one. So when I get home, my old lady knows what I need and how. A warm, heaping bowl full of looseners, castor oil flakes with real glycerin vibraphone. It doesn't just wash your mouth out. It cleans the whole system right on down the line. So come on, you little rookies. Tell your mom to get on it and do it every day. Just remember what the guys down at the precinct house sing.
Oh, it ain't no use if you ain't got the boost you get from looseners. Looseners.
The all-weather breakfast. And now we return you to Act 3 of Nick Danger, Third Eye.
When the crazy escalator ride ended, I fought my way back up to the land of the living. I came to slumped over in the front seat of my own car, lying in a pool of cheap rot gut. I had a head full of ideas that were driving me insane and a mouthful of cotton candy.
You want some more cotton candy, Danger? It might sober you up.
Oh, my head. Bradshaw, baby.
Yeah.
I never thought I'd be happy to see your ugly mug.
Save the wisecracks for the warden, Danger. I got you this time, and I got you good.
What are you talking about?
Get out of that car.
Hey, come on.
If you can stand up. And keep your hands high, I got you covered.
Hey, what's this all about, Bradshaw? You know I never carry a rod.
Yeah, but it's murder what some people can do with a car, and I got witnesses to prove it.
There's the man! Keep me away from him!
Take it easy, lady.
I don't know why you're doing this, Nancy, but it doesn't change my feelings about you.
Oh, Nick, you're such a tool! He did it!
All right, take it easy, little lady. All right, now let's get these facts straight. Take this down, Henderson. Okay, Professor, how did it happen?
Well, Sergeant...
Lieutenant.
Yes, Mrs. Farber and I were sitting right here in the living room engaged in a friendly round of spin the pickle, weren't we, dear? Yes, with our good friend Mr. Rococo. Yes, and then suddenly the door flew open and this drunken madman right here drove in, honking wildly and headed straight for us.
He's lying, Bradshaw!
Can it, Danger?
Yes, at the last possible moment, he stopped on a dime.
I see.
Unfortunately, the dime was in Mr. Rococo's pocket.
I'm going to break your neck, Catherwood!
All right, hold it, Danger. I've heard enough. We'll get the rest of the story down at the station house from you. I've been waiting for this for years.
Wise up, Bradshaw.
Week in and week out,
I didn't
Danger,
do it.
Playing second fiddle while you got all the girls.
Come on.
I'm tired of being Mr. Nice Guy. See, there's going to be some changes made. Next week, this show is going to be called...
Sergeant Bradshaw!
Lieutenant.
District Attorney!
I'm going to have my own theme music, and it's all going to take place in Washington, D.C. No plots, just girls and guys doing nice, simple things up against Nazis and fifth columnists, and no Jewish writers, either.
I saw my chance, and I took it.
In the papers.
Bradshaw
my
would never listen to my story now.
Colonel
it had more
Linder,
holes in it than
Charles
Albert Hall.
Foster Kane.
My only way out was like this!
Catherwood, stop
but I've got Bradshaw's rod pressed against Nancy's temple. Now you spill the beans or I'll blow her brain out.
I think you're bluffing, Flatfoot. No, you weren't bluffing.
All right, talk.
It all began 20 years ago. I was a freshman in college then, although you wouldn't hardly believe it to look at me now. I had just completed work on my science project, and I invited Nancy down to reveal the secret too. Well, this is it, Nancy. How do you like it?
So this is where you've been every night since we got married.
Sure is.
Oh, Nicky, I thought you were...
Danny, but don't say it, Nancy. I know it's been hard, but I wanted to give you the swellest honeymoon a girl had ever had. We're going to Greece.
And swim the English Channel?
No. To ancient Greece, where burning Sappho loved and sang and stroked the wine-dark sea in the temple by the moonlight wa-da-doo-da.
What?
Don't you see, Nancy? I've built the perfect time machine.
Oh, it sounds dangerous.
Yes, that's why I'm going to try it out first. Now, when I get into this grandfather clock, you hit me over the head with this bottle of champagne right here.
Oh.
Set the dial for 1,000 and put in 3 dimes.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be gone for 1,000 years.
1,000? Oh, that's longer than anyone's ever been gone before.
But to you it will seem only like a minute. Very well, my love. Now, forward into the past!
Gee, I hope he gets back before all this dry ice melts. Who's there?
Mrs. Haber?
Who's that?
I'm Rocky Rococo. You may have seen me loitering around the drugstore drinking chocolate malted falcons and giving away free high schools.
What are you doing here? What do you want?
I'm here for a friend, Mrs. Haber. If you sign a contract, you're supposed to keep up the payments.
Oh, you must be a friend of Nick's.
Yes.
Well, he couldn't want his money already. He only gave me the ring last night. I'm wearing it, see?
Yes, that's a very pretty hand you have there.
Ancient Greece. Look at this grape. Oh,
who are you, old man? And what have you done with my husband?
What do you mean, Nancy? I am your husband. Well, who's that ugly dwarf with his hand in your mouth, Nancy?
Rocky Rococo at your cervix.
All right, Catherwood. I've heard just enough.
What? Listen, I'm telling this story, young man. What are you doing in my flashback?
Flashback? What are you talking... Flashback. All right, all of you. You stay right where you are. Put your thumbs on your place in your script while I figure this out.
So that was her horrible secret. Poor Nancy, married to a man 1,000 years old. Now I understood why the servants had disappeared. It was Catherwood who killed Rococo to protect his wife, my Betty Jo.
Who is he talking to? How does he make his voice do that?
All right, Bradshaw, there's your confession. I hope you got it all down. Bradshaw? Bradshaw. Oh, that's right. He's not in this flashback. I'll skip ahead a bit. No, I can't skip ahead. All right, everybody. Into the time machine.
No. You don't understand how radio works. Now, this is my flashback. All I have to do to return us to the present is fade my voice out like this and cue the organist. And you see, here we are.
Oh, my goodness.
What's happening? Am I seeing double? There's two of everybody except me.
Pandemonium was breaking out all around me.
Wait a minute.
Who are you?
I was here first. You imposter. Take that.
Terrible.
You keep away from him, you young hussy.
Who are you calling a hussy, you old bag?
Well, how dare you talk to me?
I can talk to me any way I like.
Oh, what nerve. I'm not you. You're me 20 years ago.
What? You have a lot of nerve saying I'm going to look like that in 20 years?
Oh, yeah?
There ain't room enough in this dress for both of us. Get your type.
Well, this is a bit of fun, isn't it?
Yes, it certainly is, Dad. Glad to have someone my own age to talk to after all these years.
Why don't we sing something?
Well, I've forgotten the key.
Oh, that's all right. I've got a lid out in the car.
David?
Half-caste woman, living a life apart,
Where did your story begin?
Stop it! Stop cheating, you fools! Can't you see someone has been crushed here under this car? Oh, my God, it's me! I don't look at all well. I'm dead! I've been killed! Oh, this hasn't happened to me since M!
I did a quick 20-20 on the whole scene.
I thought that I was the only one going insane. But now we are all in this together.
I knew what I had to do.
I didn't like it, but that never stopped me before. All right, everybody, take off your...
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this scheduled transmission to bring you an announcement of national importance from the White House in Washington, D.C. Ladies and gentlemen... Clear, go. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
My fellow Americans, this morning at 6:25 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, combined elements of the Imperial Japanese Navy and our forces ruthlessly attacked our naval base at Pearl Harbor in the Hawaiian Islands. I have conferred this morning with the Congress and the Chiefs of Staff in emergency session. We have reached our rendezvous with destiny. It is our unanimous and irrevocable decision that the United States of America unconditionally surrender. And now my wife and I would like to return with you for the thrilling conclusion of Private Nick Danger, Third Eye.
I've solved another one for you.
Danger, I'll never know how you do it. I was sure I had the goods on you this time.
Well, Bradshaw, it's like in the army, you know. The great prince issues commands, founds states, vests families with fiefs. Inferior people should not be employed.
Nick, I can't knock success, but you still put me through too many changes.
The makers of Loosener's Castor Oil Flakes and Fantastic Cigarettes. Loosener's for the smile of beauty, Fantastic's for the smile of success, and brought you the transcribed adventures of Nick Danger, Third Eye. Tune in again next week, same time, same station, when Nick Danger meets the Arab.
All right, let's do the little...
Rolling.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, Phil, you put on the ball pit. We'll go to the other side.
How much time have we got?
Why
don't you say that? Okay, well, that's that. Yeah. How much time? Oh, look at this.
Time, okay, hey, Cyrus.
We're on now. Man.
Cyrus.
Do we have to... Yeah, okay,
I'm going
over
to...
Over the other side of the record.
Yeah. I'm going to come in from the...
Well, how long does it take to get over the other side?
Okay, wait a minute.
Just a minute or something. We haven't got...
Come on, let's go.
Have you got your ball, babe?
All right.
Come on, look. Let's just do it.
Has anybody got my script?
Any time, Cyrus. Here we go.
Scene 3, take 600.
And a death worse than fate. So... The boom of horror was unmasked at last and laid to rest by the side of his hideous clockwork dog, Toto.
Very good.
Yes, isn't it? Our labor's now completed. The great defective Hemlock Stone...